Okay, back on the record, it's 3 minutes till 11. Okay.
Yeah, I got the, this is the charge, the new patient visit, which is an office visit level three, was $190, and x-rays, three views were $88.
Okay. And doctor, I guess it's your opinion that's necessary and reasonable treatment?
It is.
Okay. You can have that too.
Do you want to mark, let's go ahead and mark that just to keep it clean. This is the next exhibit, number five. And then, doctor, I know while we were on the break, I was looking through your CV, and you have a number of publications, I guess books that you've written. One was Traumatic Disorders that was written, I guess it was published in Campbell's Operative Orthopedics, 9th edition.
That's correct.
And I guess, can you tell the jury what Campbell's Operative Orthopedics is?
That's a textbook on orthopedic surgery.
And isn't that, I guess, the most widely known textbook that's used? Is that the textbook you studied?
It is the probably one of the most widely used textbooks in orthopedics.
Okay. And doctor, I know I've asked you a number of questions about Mrs. Hussey, and asked your opinion about a lot of things. Is it your testimony that you gave all of those opinions to a reasonable degree of medical certainty or medical probability?
It is.
That's all I have.
Thank you. Dr. Pickering, I'm looking at your visit with Ms. Hussey of March 15, 2010, and your record, and you've got that.
I do. Mm-hmm.
And under the history of present illness, the second sentence is, she has been referred in today by her attorney. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so she didn't come to see you on her own last month. She came because her attorney asked her to come.
She did.
Okay, and probably because this deposition was scheduled.
I would imagine so.
Okay. To your knowledge, has Ms. Hussey sought any medical treatment for her knee since September of 2006 when you last saw her?
Not that I know of.
Okay. In fact, she had not come to see you, is that correct? In particular, she had not come to see you
for
since
that.
September of
no.
2006?
No.
For any problem that she may have been having with her left knee?
No.
Okay. And when you saw her on March 15, according to your records, she says that she still has some discomfort in her knee, but it does not prevent her from doing anything, correct?
That's correct.
Okay. Now, when you were talking about the medical bills, other than your bills that were incurred at Campbell Clinic, you've never seen the records from the ambulance, have you?
I have not.
You've never seen the records from St. Francis Hospital, have you?
I have not.
You don't have any idea what they did other than what they charged for on their bill?
I do not.
And you don't know if that was actually done, do you?
I do not.
Now, when you testified on the MRI that was taken in April of 2006 and after you first saw Ms. Hussey, and you said that she had a non-displaced fracture of the upper end of the tibia, is that right?
Correct.
And non-displaced means that there were no pieces broken off, is that right?
It means that the piece that's broken off is not out of place.
And that bone healed, is that correct?
It did.
All right. And when you describe the PCL, the PCL would be a ligament that was stretched in the knee.
When she injured her knee, she fractured where the ligament attaches to, but she also stretched out the ligament, which is why even though the fracture healed, she still had some looseness in her knee because the ligament had been stretched out.
Okay. Now, when you gave her a permanent impairment rating, I want to try to clarify what I think you were saying. The 17%, this is a chart that you look at in
it
a
is.
Book.
It's a table.
It's a table, and you look at where she fits on the table, and that tells you what her impairment rating would be.
That's correct.
And that's commonly used for workers' compensation entries, is that right?
That's right.
Okay. Now, the 17, this is not a functional disability, is it?
No.
Okay. In other words, it doesn't say that she's at a 17% loss of her ability to do anything.
Objectively. Right.
Okay. Now, the 17% to the lower extremity is where she fell on the table, is that right?
That's correct.
And that is the same thing as the 7% to the whole person, is that correct?
There's a conversion table that converts the amount of lower extremity impairment to whole person impairment. So the 7% whole person impairment is what the 17% lower extremity impairment converted to.
Okay, I just wanted to clarify and make sure for the jury that we're not talking about two separate impairments, one to the left. When you said the lower extremity, that's to her left knee, is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay, so the left lower extremity would be her left knee that we've been talking about.
Both of those impairment ratings are related to the injury to her knee.
Okay. And you certainly didn't have to perform surgery on this hussy, did you?
No.
And you don't anticipate seeing her back, do you?
No, not unless she has trouble.
Okay. And again, she didn't come to you for any particular trouble on March 15th. She came because her attorney sent her.
She did tell me that her attorney had sent her.
That's all I have. Thank you.
Doctor, just briefly. When you released her back in 2006, there was, I guess after that, there was nothing further you could really do for her. Did you agree with that?
That's correct.
So there's no real reason for her to come back and follow up with you at that point. And when we're talking about the impairment ratings, would you agree that Ms. Hussey, she's not the same person that she was prior to this accident?
That's correct.
Object to the form.
And that's a permanent issue.
That is permanent.
And that's the purpose of the rating and the impairment and everything else.
That's correct.
Okay. That's all I have.
Thank you. I appreciate
it. Thank you, Doctor.
It was easy.
And quick.
Yeah. Both of those are good things.
All right. Well,
you
got everything
you need.
I'll
see you again.
You
I hope I don't have to come
I
out.
I hope I don't see you again.
That's right. Y'all have everything you need?
Yes,
that's
sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Yep. This way.
Okay. Thank you.
Ben, I just, you never know if you're fixing to get hit with $1,000 bill. I'm like, ah! No, I mean,